If you were getting ready for a time-traveling expedition, what would you want to research before you go? Era-appropriate clothing, perhaps? Maybe what kind of food you can expect? But what about the local diseases? After all, it won't be much fun going to 19th century England only to get immediately knocked out by scarlet fever or cholera. Or what about a journey to the future, where who knows what currently harmless pathogens have mutated into existential threats? Basically, is it possible to go far enough back or forward in time to find something that will throw your immune system for a total loop? To find out, grab the keys to the DeLorean or hop in that old police box. We're going time traveling. Given that we do not have time travel yet, except for the 1 second per second we travel into the future, this is, of course, a thought experiment. But thanks to ye olde scientists taking careful notes, we can look at real historical data to make a pretty good educated guess. And thanks to ye modern scientists, we have the tools to study patterns of disease evolution to guess what the future may hold. For the first point on our timeline, we know roughly when humans popped up in the history of the world. If you go back to any time before around 300,000 years ago, you know that there will be no diseases that have evolved specifically to infect Homo sapiens. Huge win! Now, that's not to say that you're necessarily in the clear. Mosquitoes evolved around 217 million years ago, and fossil evidence suggests that they've been carrying malaria-causing parasites for at least 20 million years. Time travel notes. Bring bug spray. But if you're not planning on going quite that far back, what's the oldest human disease you might have to reckon with? Well, scientists think that humanity's oldest diseases include tuberculosis. In fact, at 70,000 years old, tuberculosis holds the official Guinness World Record for being the oldest disease that infects humans.
Oh, I'm sorry, my ears are burning. Did somebody say tuberculosis?
Did anybody else hear that? Is there like a breeze in here? Anyway, this is not to say that tuberculosis has been actively infecting humans for that long. While tuberculosis might have evolved around the time that humans started migrating out of Africa, we only have evidence to indicate it's been actually infecting us as far back as 9,000 years ago.
TB remains such a global scourge that you could write whole books about it. And I have. It's called Everything is Tuberculosis, and if you want to learn more about our deadliest infection, you can read it starting March 18th.
Thank you, John. Everybody, that's my brother. But what about some more contemporary diseases? The Black Death was one of Africa and Eurasia's most notorious killers, so you might think that you're in for a literal world of trouble if you find yourself needing to go to the 14th century for some reason. The flip side of that, however, is that if your ancestors are from Europe, the Middle East, or North Africa, around that time, at least some of them already survived the Black Death, and that might mean that you are already carrying some genetic immunity from the plague. Emphasis on that might, since we're not 100% on that one. Now, this next hypothetical is one we can be a little more sure of, since it overlaps with real life. Smallpox might be a problem for you younger time travelers out there. The disease was declared eradicated in 1980, and routine vaccination hasn't been required anywhere since 1980. Which is awesome for us right now, but maybe not so awesome if you want to pop back to any time between roughly around the 12th century BCE, when smallpox appears in the historical record, and 1980 CE. Most people born after 1982 have never had a smallpox vaccine, with a few exceptions, and most people older than that haven't gotten boosted since then because they didn't need it. Meaning, you are probably not immune to smallpox. You're not entirely out of luck, though. Smallpox vaccines still exist, and actually came in handy during the 2022 and 2024 outbreaks of Mpox. Mpox is a disease caused by a virus that is so closely related to smallpox, vaccines against smallpox are also able to keep Mpox at bay. And now, in a sort of jump to the left and a step to the right, by vaccinating people against Mpox, we are also incidentally protecting them against smallpox, which hopefully stays an unnecessary coincidence. But it is cool that protection from a right-now threat could affect your time travel itinerary.
Thank you for watching this SciShow video, and thank you for watching all of our other videos, too. Currently, we make a new SciShow video 5 days a week, but to keep up with that schedule and to keep the cool science facts coming your way, it takes a whole team of people. So if you enjoy these videos and the work of those people, including me, you can help support SciShow by signing up to receive a SciShow postcard. Each postcard comes with a science fact and a secret video. Get your own at complexly.com/postcard until February 3rd. We can't make SciShow without your help.
But honestly, the past might be more afraid of us than we are of it, because evolution is constantly resulting in more diverse viruses and bacteria, so we have many more diseases now than we did in the past. And as we march along our timeline of infection, we're seeing more and more diseases jump from animals to humans. At least so far, that process way outpaces our ability to eradicate human diseases. The list of eradicated diseases is basically smallpox. That's the whole list. So you're probably way more likely to bring a new disease to the past than for the past to give anything to you. So maybe bring a face mask and don't accidentally kill a lot of people. And on that note, if you are time traveling to the future instead of the past, there will be loads of new stuff to deal with. By the way, if you are from the year 3000, how are things? How is my great-great-great-great-granddaughter? Our TARDIS is in the shop, so I can't say for sure what you might encounter. New infectious diseases will always be popping up. On the other hand, humanity will always be coming up with better tools to deal with them. So hopefully in the future, that list of eradicated diseases will be a lot longer than just smallpox. There is one thing we can count on, though. Up until the eradication of all influenza viruses, there will almost certainly be a new flu circulating in the future that you will not be immune to. Flu likes to pop up in a new form year after year, and even if our lucky denizens of the future have access to a universal vaccine, you won't. Not yet, anyway. Luckily, your untimely demise is not guaranteed. During the 2009 H1N1 flu pandemic, scientists noticed an interesting pattern. They found out that people who were exposed to the 1918 H1N1 flu pandemic, as well as the descendants of that pandemic that circulated for decades, also got to walk away with a really valuable prize, immunity from the 2009 H1N1. It turns out that the proteins on the surface of the two flu varieties happen to be so similar that if you are immune to one, you are also immune to the other. Any antibodies trained to target the 1918 H1N1 can do some like wibbly-wobbly timey-wimey stuff and neutralize the 2009 virus too. So it's possible that any time travelers from 1918 and the following years who were exposed to the flu could hop on over to 2009 and be safe from the newer H1N1, and anyone immune to the 2009 H1N1 could possibly go back to 1918 and be good to go. So maybe keep a log of which flus you are immune to and make a note to your guide to the future to let you know when those strains pop up again, and then schedule a trip for after that. In some ways, it seems like going to the future might be more risky than going to the past, since there will be so many new germs that don't exist yet, so you can't build up any immunity to them before you go. Case in point, can you guess what might happen if we plopped someone from 2018 just a couple of years forward into 2020? Yeah, COVID-19 would make that definitely not an excellent adventure. So alongside bringing a water bottle and bug spray and some extra chapstick just in case, I'd get up to date on your shots before going time traveling, and make sure that you have like a foolproof way to get back home pretty quick.